Welcome to this brief guide on how to customize quiz options in Microsoft Forms. A quiz in Microsoft Forms is a great way to run a potential icebreaker challenge or even do an information retention quiz at the end of a training session. But there's lots of options available to us that we can customize. I'll go through them today. The first thing we'll need to do is head to our Office homepage and using the app launcher found in the top left-hand corner, select the option for Forms. Selecting this will bring us to our Forms homepage. On the Forms homepage at the top, what we'll notice is that we have any of our recently accessed or created forms. We can also select to see our favorite forms or forms that have been shared with us. But using the drop-down menu next to the New Form button, we can actually also create a new quiz if we wish. For this demonstration, I've already created a quiz called The History of Microsoft, and we'll utilize that one. Now, opening up my quiz, I can see that I have my quiz ready all about the history of Microsoft. It's a trivia quiz, it's worth 7 points, and I've got all of my questions with the correct answers selected down here, including the question around what was a computer bug even named after. I can even use the preview option to get a quick overview of what the quiz is going to look like for the respondents when they elect to complete my quiz. However, what I want to do is I want to shuffle a few things around. So I'm going to use the ellipsis menu found in the top right-hand corner, and I'm going to select the option for settings. This will give me a side pane where I can see all of the available options for my quiz, including the ability to show the results for the respondents directly after they submit the trivia quiz. This can let them see their scores and which questions they got right. I can also dictate who can fill out the form. If you're in a business, you will have the option for only people in your organization, and you can even choose to make the quiz anonymous by not recording the name, and you can limit people to only being able to submit one response. In the options for responses, you actually have a tick box to be able to limit people from being able to respond. So if you wish, you can actually say, hey, this quiz is no longer available and no longer accepting responses. And then if someone has the link to the quiz, it will no longer work. They will see your message instead. For this demonstration, obviously I'm going to need to accept responses. You can also designate a specific start date and time. So for instance, if I wanted to, I could say that this quiz is only going to be available from 2:30 p.m. until 2:45 p.m. A nice quick 15-minute quiz. And then the options that I would like down here are the ability to shuffle the questions. So I can choose to shuffle all of the questions on the quiz so everybody gets a different layout. But if I wanted to, I can actually specifically say, hey, I want to lock questions 1 and 2 so that questions 1 and 2 are always in that particular order. This is great for follow-up questions in quizzes. But in this demonstration, I'm going to shuffle all of the questions, and then I'm even going to customize the thank you message. So a lot of people are used to seeing that your response was submitted default message. But if you wish, you can actually customize it. So for instance, I can say, thank you for taking this quiz, and put a smiley face in there at the end for good measure. You also have an option to allow the respondents of your quiz to get a receipt with all of their responses after they finish submitting the quiz. And if you wish, you can also get an email notification for each time someone has responded to your quiz. And now that I've successfully set all of the options that I would like for my quiz, if I want to test it and make sure that my quiz questions are actually being shuffled, I can utilize the preview pane there, and I can see that question 2 on this particular shuffling layout is different now, and that will obviously be the case for all of the people who respond to my quiz. And that is how you customize your quiz options in Microsoft Forms. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.